se mi racconto.
In the old days of King Arthur, of whom Britain speaks great glory, this land was entirely filled with fairy power. For now, the great charity and prayers of the begging friars and other holy friars, who, as thick as moats in a sunbeam, reach every land and every stream, towns, villages, and all this causes them to be no elves. Women may go up and down safely, in every bush and under every tree. There is no incubus except him, and he will do nothing to dishonor them. And so it happened.
Pleasure in bed.
your mother. In truth, I'm just a dead man. Unless I could say what the thing it is that women desire. If you could instruct me, I would repay you well for your good work.
Fetch me a rare deer on my hand, to give it to the first thing that I require of you. It should lie on your powers. And before this night, I will sell it to you.
Take my pledge here. I agree.
Then, I tend to boast that your life is safe. For upon my soul, I will guarantee that the queen will say I said to you. Let us go on without further words. Be glad and have your faith.
Summon the knight, as it tells it to the public, and ask for the queen to judge.
My liege lady, over all this world, women desire sovereignty, as well as over her husband, as her love, and to have mastery over him. This is your greatest desire. Though you may slay me for this, do as you wish. I am at your will.
I thought tonight this answer, for which your flesh is built, if you do the first thing that I require, if it should lie on his power. Before the gods end, I pray you, sir knight, to take me as your wife, for you know well that I have saved your life. If I speak falsely, say no to me upon your faith.
Alas and alas! I know full well that this was my promise, but for the love of God, choose another request. Take all my goods and let my body go.
No, then I curse us both. For though I may be ugly, poor and old, I would like none of all the metal or ore that is buried under the earth or live upon it. Only that if you take me as your wife and you love also.
My love? No, my damnation. Alas, that any of my kindred should be so foully disgraced by such a match.
Secretly God's
family.
never yet done you any wrong. Why do you act this way on this first night? You act like a man who has done his feet. What is my guilt? Tell me, for the love of God. And if I have the power, it shall be amended.
Amended? No! No, it cannot be amended forevermore. For you are so lofty, old, and come up so low in lineage as well, that you shall wonder that I toss and turn. For the love of God, I wish my heart would grow.
Is this the cause of your unrest?
Yes, certainly, and no wonder.
No, sir. I can demand all this before 3 days have passed if I wish, so that you might bear yourself towards me well. Now you say I'm old and foul, then have the fear that you will be cuckold. For ugliness and age upon my life, a great warrant of a chastity. But nevertheless, since I know your delight, I shall fulfill your appetite. Now, choose with these two things: to have me old and foul until I die, and to be true, humble wife, never in all my days displeasing you, or to have me young and beautiful, and take your chance, or how many visits there will be to your house, or to some other place, which will be for my sake. Now, choose which one will you have.
My lady, and love, and my dear wife, I put myself into your wise governance. Please choose which may honor to you, and me also. I care not which of the two, for it's sufficient to me that I please you.
Then I have the mastery over you, since I may choose and govern as I wish.
Yes, surely, wife. I think that is for the best.
Kiss me. We will be angered no longer, for by my faith, I will be both unto you. That is to say, both beautiful, yes, and good. I pray to God that I may die mad, but I would be as good and faithful as ever as a wife since the world is new. And if I am not as beautiful to see in the morning as any lady, queen or empress, between the east and the west, do with my life as you wish, and look how it is.
Yours truly,